Good afternoon, everyone. Today, we will be joined virtually. You will have seen that the UN Interim Force in Lebanon, UNIFIL, issued a statement this morning saying that two of its peacekeepers were injured after an IDF Merkava tank fired its weapon towards an observation tower in UNIFIL's headquarters in Nakura, directly hitting it and causing them to fall. The injuries are fortunately, this time, not serious, but the peacekeepers remain in a hospital. In a separate incident, Israeli Defense Force soldiers also fired on UN position 131 in Labune, hitting the entrance to the bunker where peacekeepers were sheltering and damaging vehicles and a communication system. An IDF drone was observed flying inside the UN position up to the bunker entrance. Also, UNIFIL says that yesterday, IDF soldiers deliberately fired at and disabled the position's perimeter monitoring cameras. They also deliberately fired on UNP 132A in Ras Nakura, where regular tripartite meetings were held before the conflict began. Lights and a relay station were damaged. UNIFIL reminds the IDF and all parties of their obligations to ensure the safety and security of UN personnel and property, and to respect the inviolability of UN premises at all times. UNIFIL peacekeepers are present in South Lebanon to support a return to stability under a Security Council mandate. Any deliberate attack on peacekeepers is a grave violation of international humanitarian law and of Security Council Resolution 1701. Our peacekeepers are following up with the IDF on these matters.
What reaction has the United Nations received from the Israeli Defense Forces?
Well, we certainly are in touch with the Israeli Defense Forces, and we're trying to make sure that all further such activities that endanger the safety of peacekeepers are halted, and we'll continue with that dialogue with them.
Have you gotten any explanation?
There's nothing to share on that just yet. Obviously, it's up to the Israelis to explain their own actions.
I'll come back.
Oh, okay. Tony?
Thank you, Farhan. A follow-up, actually, on UNIFIL also. Regardless of the communications going on between the United Nations and Israeli authorities on this in this regard, my question is there any measures in place to deal with situations like this when peacekeeping forces are attacked?
We have liaison mechanisms with all of the forces in the region, and so we rely upon that to make sure that calm is restored to the area, and we're going to continue to do that. Obviously, the parties themselves have legal obligations to make sure that they abide by the relevant Security Council resolutions and also ensure the security of the peacekeeping forces that are there. Yes, Gabriel.
Thanks, Farhan. Israel's ambassador to the UN reportedly put out a statement today saying that UNIFIL peacekeepers need to move 5 kilometers north to avoid danger as fighting intensifies. Your reaction?
We have been pointing out that that there have been requests for the peacekeepers to move. Obviously, they have their mandated tasks. While we continue to assess the safety and security of our peacekeeping forces, it's important that they also fulfill their mandate, and they are at present staying in their positions.
What's the Secretary General's thinking on the viability of UNIFIL being able to continue its work, given that it's now directly being targeted by a member state?
There's no cause for any member state to target UNIFIL forces, so we will make that completely clear. The Secretary General believes that UNIFIL has a vital role to play in ensuring stability in that part of southern Lebanon, and they will continue to go about their work as mandated.
Airstrikes and fire, also another journalist,
Just a follow-up on UNIFIL. I mean, this Israeli request for the troops, the peacekeepers to move, I mean, does Israel even have the right to ask the UNIFIL peacekeepers to move, given that Israeli forces are actually violating Lebanon's sovereignty?
My basic point is that that the peacekeepers have a mandate that's been given to them by the Security Council, and they intend to fulfill their mandate to the best of their ability. Different parties can give them warnings about activity in the region, but they will assess that, and they will intend to do as much as they can to stay where they are.
Indonesian peacekeepers, what are the specific injuries?
And yes, you're right, they're Indonesian. The world to have a happy and peace. UN premises are inviolable. As a party to the 1946 Convention on the Privileges and Immunities of the United Nations, Israel is under an obligation to honor and respect that inviolability, and that inviolability is not subject to any qualification, limitation, or exceptions. Peaceful Yom Kippur. This has been